Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in Mythology, Preaching, Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to stress, you know, that in the Europe, people are mostly gone to the letters and they have no spirit or no understanding of the metaphors. And if you ask them simple question, what is a stone, and why Simon was called a stone, Peter, they have no idea at all. If you ask them how you can turn stones into bread, they will say a pebble you can turn into bread by magic, or Jesus could turn it, and all that nonsense they will talk. So much is so the blindness in letters that people of the Czech Republic, all these Russian, you know, communist countries, they all know that Samaritan woman at the well, she is St.Photina, that she was not a bad character, she was an apostle. But in the churches in England or in the West, in some part of the Germany too, they always call her, she was a bad character, and Jesus revealed her secret that she was a sinner. So what sin have to do with God, as I explained in my previous video? Those people who talk of sin in churches, they are priests, similar to those of the rabbis, which used to be in the temple, and they dealt with sin. And we in Jesus are royal priests. We have nothing to do with sin, but with the blasphemy or hypocrisy. So we deal with the hypocrisy. So these people who put on dog collars and all that, we ask them, where do you stand between man and God? When Jesus died on the cross, the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart from top to bottom. Now you can have direct approach to God through His word, not through Jesus. We have to honor Jesus for delivering us His word. So the salvation is through His word and not through Jesus. So many people, when they became dead, especially the messianic Jew have killed them, then the people who were dead in churches, they said, we apostle refused to go there because they were drunk with the old wine. We want Jesus, we want St. Paul, we want Peter, all that, you know. Then the bishop said, no worry. I will make you a statue of Jesus. Then they made a wooden statue of Jesus and putting him on cross and put the thorny crown on his head. And decorated him so that he looks nice to the ordinary man. Hey, this is Christ Jesus. Don't worry, worship him. So that's how they start to worship Christ Jesus as Lord and God. So then in the name of Jesus, when they call him Lord and God, the bishops start to rule over the people. Anybody who talked anything against their wishes or what they were telling people, they called it blasphemy, and they hanged that person, killed him. So there was no freedom of speech under the Antichrist bishops. So they dominated, and they created these schools of letters. So they, if you go to the Oxford University or other thing, ask anything what is written in the Bible, they can easily tell you this is what it means, this is written. But if you ask them, you know, what is building of the house on rock and what is building on sand, and why Christ Jesus told Peter, you are the rock over which I will build my house. They have no idea what is building on rock and what is building on sand. So I happened to ask this question to a Oxford University professor of church history. And he could not, he said, oh, I read it in the Bible, but I don't know what is building on rock and what is building on sand. So he asked the audience, about 300 or so, anybody who knows what is building on rock and what is building on sand? Nobody. I tell them, give me half a minute. So I took, they gave me half a minute. I told them that when Ananias and Sapphira, they sold their property and told lies to Peter, that when they were tested, the house was built on sand and it collapsed. They died. If they are truthful people, nobody can shake. So that is building on rock. So churches today, they are full of liars. Their priest, they are working for mammon and not for God. So they have created utter darkness, which Christ Jesus described in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, where he described the arid spirit, evil-spirited people, you know. They are the one who dominate over the other. Whereas the people who are of Holy Spirit, they make the other people equal to them in knowledge. So they give them all the expositions of the parables so that there is no stone left unturned. And that is what Christ Jesus did. And when he had emptied himself at Last Supper, then they were so perfect that nobody, a stranger, would not know which one of those is a Christ Jesus, because they were all speaking the gospel to the same standard as Christ Jesus. That is why they had to hire Judas Iscariot to pinpoint which one is Christ. So these people who are in churches, they themselves are blind guide. And how can they produce enlightened men? No way. They produce blind people. And this Samaritan woman at the well, she, her whole family were apostles. Most of the Samaritans, they became apostles of that village. And they preached gospel, and Nero killed this woman mercilessly. This, a Russian bishop had put up a story, Bishop Anthony of Sorozov. If you read of his sermons, you will find one. He has described that one. And in 1983, when I wrote the exposition of Matthew, I wrote an article in 1983 on the five husbands of the Samaritan woman, and giving their names, you know. And when I came into Reading and showed it to the local priest, look, I have found them, he laughed at me. And so I took it to London, he too laughed at me. And when I came, I was very enthusiastic. Oh, I will go to the, I was in Ghana, you know, West Africa. I will go to Britain, over there the white people will appreciate my knowledge. So when I came here, I found them dead in spirit. Even the black were much better. So these people, they don't know what stones are. Stones mean thick-headed people. Churches are full of stones. And this person who put on a dog collar and put on a uniform as a policeman does, So he becomes the policeman of God, this dog-collar priest. So like Judas Iscariot, he is a thief. Judas Iscariot used to steal money from the purse for his personal use. And this priest, at the end of the month, he say, "Hey, my salary." So he steals the purse. People donate and he steals the money out. These stones say, "Oh, yes, he needs something to live. He needs money. So it's okay. Everybody who pay donation, they also work, you know. They also live. But they do not take money out. They put money in." So such is the nature. So in Russian region, they know she was St.Photina. And in England, other thing, that lady is a prostitute. She one husband after the other. Is a very laughing, you know, stock when they tell me like that. I tell them that no, she was had a 5 spiritual husband, not the physical. Ah, no, it's written there. You can see it. So what is written, they know. And metaphors, they have no idea. The stones, they know only the pebbles lying on the road. And they don't know stones mean simple-minded, thick-headed people. Goishi Kopa, they call, the Jewish people call them. So this is the situation. And we have to awaken them. Is they have not been exposed to metaphors. They have not been exposed to the knowledge that we are giving them now. But by the grace of our Father, as Christ Jesus said, before the end of the world, the gospel will be preached. So end of the world is around the corner, as the establishment of Israel is to fulfill Matthew 13:24-30, the parable wheat and tare. So these wheat plant are those who are sons of man, who have covenant with Abraham. Remember, John the Baptist baptized Jewish men only in the name of Abraham. He never baptized a woman or a Gentile. So why they are doing so in the West? Baptizing women, children, and whatnot, you know, everything they are baptizing. When John the Baptist never baptized a Gentile or a woman. So you can see it's all darkness, you know. So I don't understand why these Russian people can't infuse the knowledge into the people of the West, that woman Samaritan woman, she was St.Photina, good work, good character. So this is the hardship. So you meet people who are dead in spirit. And this, there's one bishop who is a Russian bishop. I think it's Kalastos, something name like that. He's in Oxford. He's the bishop over there in Oxford area. So when he came into Oxford, they arranged a lecture for him to give talk. And when I heard, I went there to listen to it. And with me was a man, I forgot his name. He made the, in 1984, he made the series on the Gnostic Gospel on the Channel 4. And he was with me. So when the bishop gave a lecture in the Pusey House over there, and he was calling the chair person in the chair with the same uniform as Father. And then he was saying to this Kalastos bishop as Father. When the question time came, I asked him, you know, that I know two fathers. My physical father, from where I drive the surname and my spiritual father, God. I know these two, Father. What type of father you both are? You call each other's father? Who is father among you? Who is son? And then he said, this bishop from Russia, Paul said to Timothy, my son. So he became father. So we are also fathers. This was corruption, you know, added by the Jews. It's under comma, you know, then my son. So this is the people they have. And such are the stupidity of the men of letters.